Professor Font uses kitchen and day-to-day materials, toys, and other simple devices to communicate the wonder and joy of science to different age groups. The target participants of these workshops were school teachers. And this series of videos presented by Vigyan Prasar and Aisa Pune.
To show that exists atmospheric pressure, I put it into the water. Here, there is no liquid inside the bottle. And look, what happens? Happened nothing. Perhaps, as you said, inside 10 meters, 20 meters of water with a bottle like this, perhaps water enters the bottle. So, why water does not enter the bottle? Because perhaps there is air inside at atmospheric pressure. Here there is atmospheric pressure, here and here. So, there is no reason that water enters the bottle. Here, I have a pump. On this pump, I can put this cork, this plastic cork, and I can pump. I put my finger here, and I can pump a second and third time. It sticks here. Cork sticks in my finger because the pressure inside is less than atmospheric pressure. I take this cork, I put it on the bottle, and I pump. And I pump till I can hear the little noise. You remember? Tick, tick, tick. Yes. For this time, it's useless to continue to pump because it is the limit vacuum I can have with this pump. So I stop. I stop. And now I put the bottle into the vessel. What happens if I put out the cork of the bottle? And second question, what is now the pressure inside this bottle? So two questions. So I make the experiment. Inside the water, I put out the cork and look at the bottle. I put the cork on the bottle. What is the pressure of air here? Of course, atmospheric pressure. Mm-hmm. But before water enters the bottle, mm-hmm. I want to know what was. Yes. What was the pressure inside? Yes. More, less, or equal?
Less.
But that is to say, if pressure is less than the atmospheric pressure in the cork, it, of course, it's also less into the bottle. I have no physical instrument, so I cannot make accurate measurement. I can deduce the pressure was in the bottle before the water entering the bottle. Volume of the bottle minus volume of water upon the volume of the bottle. Expressed in atmospheric pressure, of course. Mm-hmm. So, the residual pressure is given by the volume of the bottle minus volume of water inside the bottle divided by the volume of the bottle itself multiplied by the atmospheric pressure. And about 500 millimeters. That is to say, 50 centimeters. So, the residual pressure is about 75 minus 50. 75, that is to say 25 upon 75, that is to say
1 by 3.
1 by 3.
1 third.